I live in a small wire cage my entire life.
No one loves me. No one touches me.
I live in filth.
I cry for help,
but no one comes. No one cares.
When I get sick,
no doctor comes.
No doctor comes.
I'm scared. I'm forced to breathe at every cycle.
My children are taken away from me,
and they are sick.
They often die.
I am America's dirty little secret.
Dirty little secret.
I am a multi-billion
dollar industry.
I suffer for human greed.
I am a puppy mill dog.
There's a lot of people out there that have heard the word puppy mill, but they don't really know what it means. To see and experience what a puppy mill really looks like, what a puppy mill feels like. Rows and stacks of cages. In each small cage, four or five dogs, one male and three or four females. Absolutely unable to comprehend human interaction. They're untouchable. You know, they cower to the back of the cage, extremely terrified. Did nothing but try my hardest not to cry. To see it in person and to experience what it feels like to look in the eyes of the dogs on the other side of those cages was life-changing for me. And the passion that was brewing inside of me right then, just hours after being in the puppy mills, I would not rest without doing something about it.
I am the parent of the puppy in the window.
When you buy a puppy from a pet store or over the internet,
you keep me here. You keep me enslaved.
Please love me.
Please help me.
When you stop buying, I will be safe.
I just think that, and everybody up here knows that this is the right thing to do. You know it's the right thing to do. But in my heart, I know it's the right thing to do. But to see an animal that's there and suffering, and you have the ability to do something, and you don't. Now I can...
please, Councilmember Harper, is because there's extraordinarily well-documented abuses in puppy mills.
What about the cats?
Extraordinarily.
Cats.
Would the member...
The Hunt Corporation consists of three facilities in Elkland and Goodman, Missouri, which are puppy brokerage facilities. These businesses buy puppies from breeders who arrive directly at the facilities and agents who purchase puppies from breeders throughout the country and then sell puppies at Hunt.
When the Missouri Department of Natural Resources made a complaint-driven investigation of a Hunt kennel facility in 2003, they discovered trenches of dead canines on the premises. According to department spokesman Mark Rader, most facilities bury dogs in landfills. It is rare for a kennel to bury so many dogs on site. He did not know how the dogs died. The kennel was close to violating the state's dead animal disposal laws, which allow no more than 1,000 pounds of dead animals to be buried per acre. The company was cited for clean water and waste violations. Apparently, no other investigation or inquiries were ever made regarding the trenches of dead canines. There's just not enough time to say how I could counteract most of the things said here tonight. I'm Republican. I am so pro-business that I would never stifle industry or the consumer choice. The fact is, this is an industry that violates the federal laws of the United States of America. It's federal cruelty, and federal cruelty is really not anyone's consumer choice. Whether they think it is or not, we all have to pay.
05121 in cage 32, vomiting bloody, dark yellow fluid. I told line leader Belinda about the boxer, who told me Dr. Stelzer knows exactly what's wrong with all of those puppies. The boxers in row 10, section A. Belinda told me that one of the boxers in the litter from 10A had already died and that the others will likely die too. She said that Dr. Stelzer had done an autopsy on the dead boxer, who told Belinda the puppy's insides looked like cottage cheese. Belinda did not know what the illness is called, and when I asked her if it's airborne, she replied, "I don't know."
Through all the points about why puppy mills are such an enormous problem and how they contribute to the pet overpopulation crisis in our community, or why pet stores are a problem because they are an outlet for puppy mills and the reason that puppy mills are in business. I would, however, like to address a concern raised by one of the council members at the last meeting who suggested that Huntington Beach doesn't need a puppy mill ordinance because Huntington Beach doesn't have puppy mills. While it may be true that there are no brick-and-mortar, high-volume commercial breeding facilities in Huntington Beach, what Huntington Beach does have are stores selling puppy mill dogs imported from outside the city, so it is still a very undeniable problem. Just like Huntington Beach may not have any methamphetamine labs in the city, if methamphetamine is being manufactured elsewhere and being sold in the city, that would be an issue that I would think you would want to address. And yes, puppy mills are legal and methamphetamine is not, but the issue is the same. Puppy mills are an inhumane industry that you've all agreed you don't want to support, and yet the byproduct of that industry is being sold in your city.
Inhumane conditions that these dogs are living in every day, day in and day out.
All this dog knows how to do
this. Hi, my name is Brian Manal. I'm the senior investigator for Last Chance for Animals. I just wanted to address a couple issues. Some people were talking about puppy mills and how long, you know, how old are these videos? Well, I've probably been to more puppy mills than most people in here. I've been to literally hundreds of puppy mills from Pennsylvania to Hawaii. Yes, there are tons of puppy mills in California, South Dakota, Texas, all over. Last puppy mill I was out to was 2.5 months ago. Got people in the field right now. These videos are current. Dogs are dying. Dogs are freezing. Dogs. Let's put away this policy. This is going on right now. These dogs, as we speak, debating this issue tonight. dogs are in these cages. They're never getting out. I've personally seen thousands of dogs who spent their entire lives in these wire cages. They don't know how to walk on the ground. We take them out of the cage. They are frightened of the ground. They've never actually put their feet on the ground.
My name is Rene Kerapedian. I'm the proud owner of Pet Rush Pet Store in the city of Glendale. I was the first pet store that became humane, took the humane model in the city of Glendale. And since not only I've not gone out of business, but it really put us on the map. I became a lot more successful. I became a lot more known in the city. And since last year, we were responsible for adopting out over 300 dogs out of my little hole-in-the-wall pet store in the city of Glendale. These are dogs that all came from county shelters that did not stand a chance otherwise. Every time I go to the shelters and I look at these dogs, this is one dog that I know I can save. And yes, one less dog that I could have bought a dog from a puppy mill. I have. I did sell. I made money. But now I can tell you honestly from a business person, I'm making more money. I have a lot more clientele that trust me, knows me by name. They come to the store for me, and they honor what I've done. And that's what I would like to see these other two stores to become. So I'd like to offer my help to these other two stores to show them how they can embrace this humane model and what they have to do to become very successful. I tripled my income. I'm a living proof that this is not only possible, but it's very easy to do. The community will support. They will not only survive, but they will make money. And the dogs are out there. The puppies are out there. The recipes are full of puppies. I go every week, and there's a ton of them. And it will cost you actually a lot less to get one of these dogs out of county shelter, spay-neutered, microchipped, vaccinated, temperament tested. None of those are true with these puppies they get from puppy mills. Thank you for your time.
Just a change. I think that's fair. Just to reiterate a little bit why I'm supporting this is it's been established there's no puppy mills in Huntington Beach. I think it has been established, Councilman Dwyer, that they use the Hunt Corporation, which is the broker that gets their dogs from puppy mills around the country, and therefore we help, through supply and demand, keep that puppy mill business, the demand there. So we are part of that component. The whole puppy dog in the window, the spontaneity of it. And in the best case scenario, someone finds a little puppy, 8 to 12 week old puppy or kitten with the paws too big, fumbling around. Is there anything cuter? And it may be healthy and it may be loved and it all may work out just fine. But we have the $500,000 we're putting down, so there's a supply and demand issue there. There's the ones that go sick. There's the folks that buy spontaneous without telling somebody. I don't even like the ones we do. I'll talk to my board, Boys and Girls Club. They get pet and a ton, spontaneous. Someone's had a few drinks and get it for their wife. And, it's not overall the best way to make such a purchase. Irvine Company, largest landlord in Orange County, has implemented a ban. No more selling of or leasing to pet stores, basically. I think they only had one tenant left. They're done.
I had businesses, I had clothing business, restaurants, and I know exactly where you're coming from. But if you have to make adjustments to your business, then you're going to make those adjustments. I'm not here to put you out of business, and I don't want to do that. I discussed this with Councilman Shaw, and I listened to what he had said, and I'm willing to work with him. I'm willing to work with you, and this young lady up there is willing to sit down and do anything it takes to make it work. So,
I just wanted to clarify that I can't take total credit for this. The day after you directed me, the city of Los Angeles adopted an ordinance very similar to this. So when we started our meeting, everybody already knew what our dialogue was going to be. So,
you still did a very good job. Thanks.
Mayor Pro Tem.
Guide you through the darkest of your days. If a great wave shall fall and fall upon. still go on in your heart, in your mind. I'll stay with you.
I believe that by caring for our nation's veterans while at the same time providing assistance dogs to those with physical disabilities, we create a win-win scenario for everyone. This is a goal we can all be proud to accomplish. And just as an added bonus, we provide these wonderful animals with a loving and safe environment. And that's why I strongly urge all of my colleagues to join in me in support of H.R. 2074. And I yield back the balance of my time.
I know now just quite how my life and love might still go on in your heart, in your mind. I'll stay with you.
By my side, I will fight and defend. I'll fight and defend. Yeah, yeah. Keep holding on, 'cause you know we'll make it through. We'll make it through. Just stay strong, 'cause you know I'm here for you. I'm here. There's nothing you can say, nothing you can do. There's no other way when it comes to the truth. So keep holding on, 'cause you know we'll make it through, we'll make it through. Hear me when I say I believe. Nothing's gonna change, nothing's gonna change destiny. Whatever's meant to be, well, work out.
States supplying stores with 500,000 puppies a year. It's all about quantity and profit, with little, if any, care given to the individual animals. In fact, the conditions common to most mills are so inhumane, the dogs are left in various states of physical and mental anguish. Just how cruel is the pet shop business? See for yourself.
You're not alone, together we stand. I'll be by your side, you know I'll take your hand. When it gets cold and it feels like the end, there's no place to go, you know I won't give in. No, I won't give in. Keep holding on, 'cause you know we'll make it through, we'll make it through. Just stay strong, 'cause you know I'm here for you, I'm here for you. There's nothing you can say.
Where salespeople said the dogs were from California and even provided documentation. But the owners later discovered they were smuggled from Mexico.
When you go to Fashion Island, you don't expect to be buying a $5 dog off of the back of a truck that's just come in from Mexico.
And have hidden dangers.
Most of these puppies are too young. You know, they have underlying diseases and illnesses that you can't really detect, you know, in a 5-minute inspection on a puppy.
A dog off of the back of a truck that's just come in from Mexico. Here, put some more on your puppy.
Lie, because the truth is horrific, and they know that if we found out that these dogs came from these abused living conditions, that we would stop buying these puppies.
Somewhere far along this road, lost soul. So
moment so heartless? How could you be so heartless? How could you be so heartless? How could you be so cold? As the wind went when it breathes you. Just remember that you were talking to me though. Neither was the way you're talking to me, yo. Mean after all the things that we've been through. Mean after all the things we got into. Y'all know some things that you ain't told me. Y'all did some things, but that's the old me. Now you wanna get me back and you gon' show me. So you walk around like you don't know me. You got a new friend, I got homies. In the end, still so lonely. In the night, I hear him talk. Cold story lives home. Somewhere far down this road, lost a soul. To a moment so heartless. How could you be so heartless? How could you be so heartless? How could you be so toxic to evil? Bringing out a side of me that I don't know. I decided we weren't gonna speak, so why we up 3 a.m. on the phone? Why does she be so mad at me for? Homie, I don't know, she's hot and cold. I won't stop, won't mess my groove up, cause I already know how this thing go. You run and tell your friends that you're leaving me. They say that they don't see what you see in me. You wait a couple months, then you gon' see. You never find nobody better than me in the night. Cold story ever told. Somewhere far down this road, lost a soul. To a woman so heartless. How could you be so heartless? How could you be so heartless? Talking, 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 talk. Baby, let's just knock it off. They don't know what we've been through. They don't know about me and you. So I got something new to see. You just gon' keep hating me. We just gon' be enemies. I know you can't believe I could just leave it wrong. And you can't make it right. So I'ma take off tonight. Into the night. Hear 'em talk. Thank you.
named Gresh, and old mother dies. Try to make this kind and clear, just a chance that maybe we'll find better days. 'Cause I don't need boxes wrapped in strings and designer love and empty things, just a chance that maybe we'll find better days. Simple where we could live, and something only you can give, and that's faith and trust and peace while we're alive. And the one poor child who saved this world, and there's 10 million more who probably could if we all just stopped and said a prayer. So take these words and sing out loud, 'cause everyone's forgiven now, 'cause tonight's the night the world begins again.
No civilized society should ever allow dogs to be raised in these kinds of conditions. This absolutely has to stop.
Two brothers shot 80 dogs in Berks County. We had a candlelight vigil to pay for ours.
No hell below us, above us on the sky.